thought you all might begin your tour here.
Kevin! What up, dude?
How's it going?
You ready to make a skydive?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you look like you're ready, bro.
I still have to take my glasses off so you can see how scared I am.
Ah! Dude, don't be scared. This guy's going to take good care of you. That guy right there. Right there. You ready, bro?
We'll see how it goes.
Yeah. Dude, we're going to have a great time.
I'm a little nervous about having a separate harness,
I think. Let me see that thing,
woven into me.
Oh, yeah! Dude, it's going to be great. 14,000 feet. We're gonna cook out 120 or so miles an hour.
You say 14,000?
Yeah, 2.5 miles, bro. Nah.
Oh man.
It's gonna be awesome. Here. 10 minutes, we'll be in the airplane. See you there.
All right. Back
thumbs up. Right.
point of life is.
Cheers. You were really nice neighbors.
But today I'd like to talk to you about a serious problem in the Zord, drugs. To combat this problem, the police have formed a special task force. This squad has come to be known as the Zord Vice.
Alright, that's a wrap.
Yes!
Don't either.
Next week. I need 2 kilos. Can you get that much?
I've handled much bigger things than that.
Hello!
I'll meet you in the old factory at 2 o'clock on Saturday.
I assume we'll discuss my fee at that time.
Yes, you are correct, sir.
I expect to be paid in full at the time of delivery.
We will not shortchange you, adult man. No, sir.
Mr. Crockett, Royal Flush.
Received word from Officer Manning that you called him Big Nose.
Normally, I would issue you a month suspension without pay, but I need you for this case you're on. But be warned, one more dirty name and I'll bump your butts right off this force. Your equipment's in the supplies room. Now get out of here.
Yes, sir.
Oh, got the money from the radio closet. There's only one head left. I had to get it from the old box. This thing isn't even cordless. It was state of the art in its day. And remember, the phone you run the recorder was on.
Let's go make a deal.
Excellent!
Well, Chief, we made the deal. Person wants 2 kilos of marijuana at noon on Wednesday. We'll be getting paid $1.5 million for it.
We're making our drop at the old abandoned plutonium warehouse.
Excellent! Now I'll work on getting you pansies some backup. And I can get the marijuana from impound. And this time, the stuff's gonna be fake. So don't you greaseballs get any retarded ideas about keeping it for yourselves, or I'll throw your bodies in the slammer rot. I'll have the backup there by 11, so they'll be in place by the time you get there. They'll come out the instant you give them the money and get the drugs. Hello, impound? This is Chief Gates. I need 2 kilograms of imitation marijuana. Special agents Rico and Crockett will be by to pick it up. They'll have it waiting for you. Don't screw up. Now get out of here!
Yes, sir.
I love this job.
Oh, thank you, Ed.
Fun. Yeah. Dang it!
Hello again, Sergeant Sweet Chuck.
Hello again.
I got stuff that you requested. The heck? These are maple leaves.
And no one's gonna believe this is marijuana.
Yeah, but at least with airplane goo, if you sniff it, you find how the kite.
Oh, and by the way, man, I'm sorry about leaving the donut shop.
Wow, I just can't believe it's Wayne Newton on the phone, not as a guest on a TV show.
3, go.
If you come by, I'd like to have your autograph. And if it isn't too much, my wife would like one of your handkerchiefs for a scrapbook.
Oh, Ed, you're so kind. Would you please put Johnny on the phone?
Sure thing, buddy. Hello, Wayne. All things in Las Vegas, the city of lights.
Great, Johnny. Now what about the shipment? I'd like to have it by Wednesday. There's a National Rifle Association convention at the hotel I'm working this weekend. And those guys smoke weed like a chimney.
I've been talking with a possible supplier, and I'll find out Saturday if he can make the deal. I'll get in touch with you after I find out the straight stuff.
What's that?
Oh, Ed wants to talk to you again. Something about...